Nigeria, as in many places, the pursuit of a better life drives young people to seek every opportunity they find. It's heartbreaking that in doing so, some lose everything, including their lives. This was a tragic reality for three young women, Inyobong Umorin, Ijeoma Nweke, and Bamise Anyanwole, who were just trying to make an honest living, only to fall victim to senseless violence. Inyobong Umorin was a 26-year-old graduate from the University of Uyo in Akwa Ibom State, awaiting her youth service. She was described as someone who was disciplined, generous, and driven. Having lost both her parents early on, Ini learned resilience through hardship. Funding her own education, she worked tirelessly, sometimes even missing classes, to earn enough to get by. Even after graduating, she actively searched for work to secure her future. On 27th of April 2021, driven by her desire for a stable income, Ini took to her Twitter profile to hunt for a job. She sent out a tweet, hoping someone would help her find work. Scrolling through responses to her job inquiry on Twitter, one message caught her eye. A man named Ezekiel mentioned an opening for a secretary on a local farm and shared his contact info. Eager for the opportunity, she reached out to him. Tragically, this call for opportunity became a trap. Ezekiel directed her to meet him in a remote part of Uyo, explaining that it was where the job site was located. Eager but cautious, she informed her close friend of the meeting, sharing her concerns about the distance. It was further than she planned to travel, and she didn't even have the fare. Her friend, concerned but supportive, encouraged her, even giving her money for transport. Arriving at the designated location, Ini immediately sensed that something was wrong. The location was isolated, and nothing about it seemed like a professional setup. She quickly called her friend again, sharing her exact location and voicing her concerns. Her friend urged her to leave if she felt unsafe. Sadly, her instincts were correct, and she didn't get that chance. What she thought was a job interview was a trap set by 20-year-old Frank Uduak Akman, who had no job to offer. Obviously, Akman sexually her. She bravely fought back, even managing to reach out to her friend by phone one last time during the struggle, but it was too late. He overpowered her. After he was done, he killed and buried her in a shallow grave right there at the abandoned site. Akman later surrendered to the police after his father was arrested and confessed to his crimes.
What did you use to beat her?
The same cigar that she used to. And I am pressing her.
Where did you used to hit? Where did you hit her?
When police investigated the site, they discovered evidence suggesting that this same location had been used multiple times, uncovering other shallow graves and disturbing remnants of his previous victims.
Was she your first victim?
Yeah.
So how many have you killed in that process?
I've not killed anybody.
How many girls? Have you done that too? Whether they died or they did not die. How many? Yes.
About six.
What? Ini wasn't his first victim, though he claimed she was the first he had killed. Her disappearance sparked outrage across Nigeria, with social media campaigns calling for justice under the hashtag Justice for Ini Umorin. By August 4th, 2022, Frank Uduak Akman was sentenced to death by hanging. This sentence brought some closure, but her loss remains a painful reminder of the dangers young women face when seeking job opportunities. As we mourn Ini's tragic fate, her story, heartbreaking as it is not an isolated incident. Across the country, another young woman would meet a similar fate, a bright, talented artist named Ijeoma Nweke. Ijeoma Nweke, a 27-year-old makeup artist from Enugu, was passionate, professional, and dedicated to her craft. A graduate of Imo State University, she was steadily building her brand, bringing beauty and happiness to her clients, one makeup session at a time. She was dating Chidi Ebere Opara, and her life seemed filled with promise. But fate took a tragic turn on the 11th of November 2020 when she accepted an appointment from a new client. Like any professional, she prepared her kit and set out for what she assumed would be another routine job. Before leaving, she expressed her doubt to her brother and her boyfriend. Something about this request just didn't feel right to her. Yet, she proceeded, not wanting to miss an opportunity. She couldn't have anticipated the horror that awaited her. When Ijeoma didn't return home and her phone became unreachable, her family grew increasingly worried. Their worst fears were confirmed days later on the 16th of November, when her body was found discarded in a refuse dump in Maryland, Enugu. Police investigations uncovered a horrifying motive. They arrested two suspects, Chiamaka Ifeazue and her brother, Emeka Ifeazue, who had plotted her death in an act of jealousy. Chiamaka, bitter over her ex-boyfriend's relationship with Ijeoma, devised this twisted plan to eliminate her perceived rival. Knowing Ijeoma's profession, she arranged the fake makeup appointment to lure her. Ijeoma, who had never even met Chiamaka, walked into the trap unaware, simply trying to earn a living. When she arrived, Chiamaka and Emeka ambushed her, torturing her for days and ultimately force-feeding her a poisonous substance. Can you even imagine the fear and confusion she must have felt in those final moments? She didn't have the slightest idea who these people were. Chiamaka and her brother discarded her body and poured acid over her remains, an attempt to erase her identity. It's sickening just thinking about it. The brutality of this act left the community in shock. Although Chiamaka was sentenced to death by hanging on February 7, 2024, Emeka's involvement was dismissed during the trial, leaving a bitter sense of injustice. As heartbreaking as Ijeoma's story is, it is disturbingly not unique. In the bustling city of Lagos, Bamiche Ayanwole's own hopeful life was cut short during what should have been a routine bus ride. Bamiche Ayanwole, a 22-year-old fashion designer in Lagos and the youngest of 10 siblings, had a lively personality and big dreams for her brand. On the evening of February 26, 2022, after a long day at work, she boarded a government-operated BRT bus at around 7:30 p.m., intending to surprise her older brother's family with an impromptu weekend visit. Little did she know, this simple ride would tragically become her last journey. She expected a simple, safe ride home. However, she sensed something was wrong immediately she got on the bus. The bus was oddly empty. The interior was dark. The driver, who had flirted with her as she boarded, instructed her to sit at the back, which was an unsettling request. With sharp intuition and a proactive mind, Bamiche began recording videos and sending voice notes to her friend, Felicia. She even captured the plate number of the bus. Bamiche was literally documenting her fears in real time. Felicia, concerned for her safety, advised her to get off at the next bus stop. Bamiche's unease grew, and in her final message, she whispered, "Please pray for me." Then the communication stopped. Her loved ones could no longer reach her. On 7th of March 2022, her body was discovered near the Carter Bridge in Lagos. Witnesses reported seeing her thrown from a moving vehicle. The BRT driver was identified as Andrew Nice Omenikoron. After Bamiche's disappearance was made public, he fled and went into hiding in the neighboring Ogun State. He was tracked down and arrested by DSS, that's Department of State Security, and was handed over to the police for questioning. He initially confessed to her and disposing her body, but later he changed his story, claiming armed men had hijacked the bus and abducted her.
She forced herself out of the bathroom. She was crying for help. Because of dirty act I've done has to be there. I'm afraid.
Why did I run, sir? When those guys showed me the weapon, as I was saying, sir, I was kind of, I can't be myself anymore. Fears have come in me. So whatever the man on guns sit down there, whatever he tell me, it's what I do. When I follow that Carter Bridge, after they had to overhead bridge, they ordered me to stop there. And when they ordered me to stop, so I should open the door. When I open the door, then the nurse track, when they come down, the nurse start dragging her down. When I saw she was crying for help, actually, I'm helpless. So I was just thinking that she's inside.
Public outcry surged, leading to protest demanding better safety on public transport. BRT operations were even suspended in Lagos temporarily as at that time. Bamiche's family continues to fight for justice as the trial drags on, with Andrew facing 5 counts of murder. We can only hope that in the end, this family receives the justice they so rightfully deserve. These young women didn't just fall victim to tragic circumstances. They did everything they could to protect themselves. Ini shared her location. Ijeoma confided her doubts to her family, and Bamiche documented her fears in real time. They were cautious, they were aware, and they were proactive. Yet, it wasn't enough. Their only crime was trusting others while striving to achieve their dreams. So what does this say about the security and protection women deserve in our society? May we remember these beautiful souls, not only as victims, but as courageous women whose stories inspire a call for justice, vigilance, and a safer society where young women can pursue their dreams without fearing for their lives. So that's it for today, guys. Please share your thoughts in the comment section. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more true crime stories. Thank you for watching. Bye.